Okay, so if they had this when I was in school, I would have been an A student.
Camosun College is offering a course on the greatest music of all time.
Heavy metal.
We're gonna meet the instructor. Let's rock.
Pink bicycles? Not what I was expecting.
Greg Pratt is not your stereotypical heavy metal fan. He's a father, writer, and editor who also happens to love metal. Greg did a metal radio show at UVic for 15 years and served as a judge in the metal category for the Juno. He's interviewed some of the biggest names in the industry, including the lead singer of Metallica.
I love you, James!
I was nervous as heck, right? Of course, you know, like, I've done a zillion interviews, I don't get too nervous anymore, but I mean, face to face with the guy you kind of grew up listening to.
Now at the age of 37, he's taken his lifelong love of metal and turned it into a continuing studies course.
What I wanted to get across was that there's a lot more to it than people might realize. Especially with the more extreme kinds of metal, people focus on the vocals, which are the kind of Cookie Monster growled vocals, and they kind of laugh it off when the musicianship is phenomenal. Yeah.
So is it just metalheads like myself taking Greg's course?
There's people who are like diehard metalheads, there's people who know nothing about metal, and there's people who are just kind of dipping their toes in, and new metal fans who are, you know, new in the past couple of years and want to learn more. So it's really all over the map. Sometimes if I play a grindcore album for someone who's not open to it, it just sounds like, you know, World War III. It just sounds, you know, they run away. But the students all seem quite willing and quite ready to discuss it. You know, no one's laughing at the albums yet, so that's a good sign.
What would a homework assignment be?
Homework assignments, I've been getting the students to listen to two albums, and then they'll have either a reading or a like to watch a video online. It's important to metal fans who take metal so seriously, it becomes part of their life and their identity. It's not like a lot of forms of music where you just put it on and enjoy it and then go about your day, which is fine and great. But for metal fans, it becomes a way of life. Metal is often referred to as a religion.
One of the knocks on metal over the years has been its association to the devil, which Greg says has been greatly exaggerated.
The 80s, the culture in general, kind of the climate of the culture in general, there was satanic panic, there was hysteria. Are there actual satanic metal bands? You know, there's a couple, maybe, but it's certainly not this huge. Like, as soon as you guys leave, I'm not gonna go drink blood. I'm gonna go to work. Like, you know, like, we're just kind of normal people.
Camosun College's The History of Heavy Metal course starts September 18th.
In Victoria, I'm Kim Rock.
Two, three, four.